one day I literally woke up and decided that I wanted to be a barber. My name's Shane, I'm 36 years old, from San Mateo, California, and I'm a barber. I literally woke up on a Friday morning, called the barber college, and by Tuesday morning I started. And since then, my love for barbering and the trade and the art of barbering has only grown like tenfold.
Barber school is going, and I meet a guy, Shane Nesbitt over there. I'm Carlo Contreras. I'm a barber at the San Mateo Zoo. It's been about almost 10 years. Shane, he's the only white guy in that barber college, you know? It's nothing but blacks, Hispanics. You know, me and my friend Jeremy were the only like Asian dudes there. And then here comes that white guy, you know, tatted up, like, who's this guy?
And it was on 3rd Street in Hunters Point. And I had never cut hair in my life. I didn't know what I was doing. I knew what a clean haircut looked like. I knew what a clean fade looked like.
We know that he never cut a hair in his life. He just gets in there and just tries to be a barber. And you know, so me and Jeremy trying to help him into, you know, get into barbering. And this guy gets good like that.
That's where it all started right then. This guy Ray that used to cut my hair was an older gentleman. He was older at the time even, and he was from Jordan originally. And he had been about, I know he's still cutting hair now, but he was in San Mateo and he was kind of like the only guy that could do a good, you know, a clean fade. And he was swift with the straight razor and he inspired me. I mean, like going to his shop and seeing the Playboys on the table and you know, it smelled like aftershave, the smell of the barber shop. It's like something that you'll never forget.
You know, my grandfather used to own a beauty salon. You know, and so as a kid, I used to get paid $5 to sweep up hair, and you know, I probably would have got the money anyway. But you know, I just remember this environment where my grandfather was able to provide for himself and his first family. My name's Travis Sweeney. I'm 38 years old. I work here at Shane's Barbershop and Shave Parlor in San Mateo, California. I've spent so much time here in San Mateo. You know, I work closely with another nonprofit here in San Mateo, Project 90. And so my heart has been with that organization for a long time. You know, and Shane's been a really good supporter of that, helping out with free haircuts. They would do raffles. You know, every morning at 7 a.m., a group of guys walks by the shop. We say hello. You know, and I get to see people from our community, you know, get well. You know, and that's what this is about.
I think I was about 11 or 12 when I first picked up a set of clippers. My dad, my uncles, my grandfather, we all cut hair. And, you know, we didn't cut hair because we were trying to make money. It was because cutting hair was something that men knew how to do in my family. The first time I stepped in Shane's shop, I was just a customer. There's so much time that's put into the haircuts over here, and my folks were like, trip, you know, some of them were like, yeah, dude, man, that's a big jump, $14 to $40. And then they get cut and they're like, oh my God, let me schedule my next appointment.
Cut so many different types of people. I mean, you'll have a lawyer in one chair getting cut, a cop in another chair, and like a street kid in the third chair. And it's just like, but everyone will be conversating and having fun. Everybody wants to talk, everybody wants to hang out, and they love the energy here.
What we've done is we've established a pretty consistent way of offering a service. And the more we stick to that formula, the more consistent we are, and the experience is the same for every customer.
The reason I put my name on this shop is because I'm so proud of the way that it's run. Reason being, every time that I have a client, I treat the client virtually the exact same way that I would like to be treated.
I have never seen someone come in once. Just once, you know. They'll definitely be back. They'll always be back.